a lot of people talk about the it factor, the X factor, that one thing that they think certain people have that most people don't have. They'll look at someone, whether it's someone's aura or their energy or their demeanor, something about them, they go, what is it that, that person knows, or what is it that that person sees? What do they have that other people seem to pick up on that I don't personally see myself about that person? And so there's a lot of layers to what people call the it factor. But everybody has the it factor. It's just really how you tap into it. And the biggest thing that I can think of when I think about the it factor is really how well people cope with the concept of their own death. It's how solid people are with that. Because if you think about it, there's certain things about yourself that you're not going to change. So, for example, you're not going to change the fact that you're a white guy, or a black guy, or an Asian guy, or a Mexican guy, or you're 6'5", or you're 5'2", or you're a woman, or you were born rich, or you were born poor. Like, there's certain things about your circumstance and who you are that you're not going to change. So it's taking that card, that character, that avatar, that person that you are in this physical world, it's taking that and owning it like that's just what you wanted to be the whole time. Because I'm mixed race. I'm half black, half white. I'm not Asian. So I'm not going to sit around like, oh, how come I can't be like Bruce Lee, or how come I'm not Michael Jordan? How come I'm not this person? That's not the it factor, that jealousy thing, that wishing you were the other guy, not looking at things consciously. That's not the it factor right there. The it factor is taking that piece that you have and just owning that piece. And so back to the concept of what I'm talking about with death is just understanding yourself well enough to have coped with it on a brighter level, to understand your mortality in this world. And when I say mortality in this world, I don't mean forever, because we are, energetic beings, spiritual beings. So this is continuous. So even though we pass on in this form, there's other realms and other stuff going on here in the spiritual sense. And that's for a completely different video. But when I'm talking about this it factor, it really is that. It's a grounded sense of who you are, being okay with yourself and understanding the concept of your own death, and that's going to happen one day, and not looking at it in a bad way or like a sad way, but just understanding it as a part of life. Like, look, this is what I am. I'm not 6'6", I'm not 250 pounds, I'm not Asian, I'm not Mexican, I'm not a woman. I am what I am. I am the things I am, and that's the piece I am, and I don't want to be the other person. And that's the it factor. It's using that to what you can call your advantage. If you look at a guy that's 5'2", he could go through his whole life looking at how he's, a short guy, and he could feel a certain way about it. Or another thing he can do is find the humor in it, maybe use it to his advantage. Maybe he goes into stand-up comedy, and the fact that he's that short plays into his role of being funny, and he uses the things he was given to leverage his own income, to leverage his own means of survival to get through the world. So, at the end of the day, we're just all living creatures that need to eat food and sleep and survive and basic human necessities. So taking your piece and understanding how that's navigating itself into the world, and so you can put food on the table and survive day to day, that's the it factor. You can't just sit there constantly comparing yourself. If you keep comparing yourself on stuff that's very petty for your current age and where you should be with your mindset, then that's not the it factor. The it factor is just a grounded sense of being, a grounded sense of self, just knowing yourself, being present in the moment, having a sense of your future and where you're going, and preparing for things, and not, just being lazy with no motivation, no goals, but at the same time being very present in the current situation. So it's a very hard balance to find, but that's really what it is. It's like, yes, I have goals. Yes, I have things that I want to achieve. Yes, I'm looking for answers, looking for truth in the world. Yes, I'm trying to figure myself out more, figure out other people, figure out the importance of things, the meanings of things, the meanings of life, why things are the way they are, why we think the things that we do, why we act the way we act, our relationships with other people. So there's a lot going on to make sense of, and you're going to have those questions. But the it factor is just having some solidarity with that. It's not, you know, it's not like wishing you were the other guy or wishing you had his possessions. Or if you do have those feelings, it's like, be curious about it. Like, oh, he started a great company. How do I start a company? Or he, you know, he, that guy's drinking water, not drinking a bunch of alcohol. Like, how do I get healthier? It's a continuous mode of learning and expanding off the other person. Solidarity, being comfortable with your own death, being comfortable with who you are. You are the character that you are. You weren't born as the other person, and that's the it factor.